Kevin, let's talk about residential construction projects. What is your data telling you about recent housing starts in Canada?
Well, it's certainly been a very strong period over the past while. Certainly nothing anybody would have expected in a global pandemic. And so that dates back to 2020, where we had, you know, sort of more housing starts in 2020 than we had had in 2019, which I don't think anybody ever would have predicted. And as everybody has seen, you know, that has sort of continued through 2021. We're starting to see headlines now where the market is slowing a little bit, but I would call that more of a stabilizing period right now, where we get back to probably what we would consider a new normal in terms of activity. And we we have a new indicator at the Canadian Home Builders Association called the Housing Market Index. That's a measure of builder confidence. And so that sort of precedes even permits and starts, and looks at what's going on in sales offices. And we are seeing a very high number. You know, in the single family market, we're seeing 82.9 out of 100, which is quite high. And looking, you know, at similar numbers, even a little bit higher in the condo market. So we have a strong market right now. And certainly from the builders and developers' perspective, from their sales offices, an expectation that that's going to continue for the next while.
I want to get into a few things there that you had just mentioned, but when you take a look at markets across the country, what stands out for you? What are you seeing West Coast versus East Coast?
Well, I think one of the encouraging things, if I could say that, is that we have pretty strong demand across the country, and that's not always the case. You know, with the Canadian economy being what it is, a lot of the times, you know, things are stronger in one region while another region is suffering a little bit. And that's just the nature of a big country with diverse economies and different things that drive the market across the country. Over the past couple of years, we've seen a real emphasis on home by Canadians. And as a result, we're seeing strong demand and strong residential construction activity in every province. And I think at a time of economic recovery, when unfortunately other parts of the economy have been suffering, the ability to still provide those jobs and keep that economic activity going from coast to coast has been a real strength.
Kevin, let's go back and pick up on something that you had touched on with respect to single family versus multifamily. Multifamily, of course, condos and apartments. You had suggested that the Canadian Home Builders Association, the HMI index, had suggested that the demand for single family has been greater than multifamily. Has that always been the case?
You know, certainly, you know, in the early stages of the pandemic and through 2020, you could really see that move by Canadians into different places. And there's been a lot of movement sort of out of city cores based on people looking for more space and also being able to work from home. And so actually in 2020, we also saw an increase in single family starts as compared to 2019, which we hadn't seen in a long time. There's been this big move over to multifamily construction for many, many years. And so to have more starts in low rise and in single detached than prior was a big change. Now we are seeing though that the condo market and multi-unit market has caught up again. And so we're sort of seeing a balance and some strength on both sides of the market, both the high rise, mid rises, as well as the low rise, which is still very strong.
Help us understand the cost of building material, because we have been hearing the rising cost of lumber, just the overall construction costs that go into building a project now, Kevin.
Yeah, it's been a real challenging year on that front. I think the supply chain issues have been well documented, and certainly lumber was the headline for almost a year. And we saw, you know, prices of a dimensional lumber, so your 2x4s or 2x6s going up 200-300%, just astronomical numbers. We were seeing numbers in the first and second quarter of a majority of our members talking about house prices going up because of those construction costs on lumber alone by 30,000, almost a quarter of them by 40,000. So big numbers going up. Fortunately, those lumber prices have started to come down. That's starting to stabilize, still at higher numbers than prior to the pandemic, but something certainly more palatable than those really high prices. At the same time, though, we have seen an increase in almost every other construction material and product in the orders of 10 to 20% across the board, from appliances to just about anything, plastics, plumbing. It's been the whole world has seen a supply chain disruption and challenges. Shipping has been a big problem internationally, and that is definitely finding its way into costs of construction across the board.
You mentioned supply chains, and of course, we're talking about availability. How does that change the timeline of these projects?
The timeline has been affected very much over the course of the past year. Our last survey of builders was still showing some pretty significant delays across the country. We had an average delay on closings of about 7 weeks. Some a little bit less, some a little bit more, depending on the region. And that is very much a function of just the inability to get materials in some cases because of the international challenges. In some cases, it was because of plant shutdowns, because of COVID. Kitchen cabinets supposed to arrive, in 2 weeks, and all of a sudden the kitchen cabinet company had to shut down. And so you're trying to find alternatives. So that's one of the things that we've also been trying to express to those people in the market, who have purchased a new home. Certainly, if your builders are explaining to you that there are delays, this has been very much the problem and very much out of builders' hands. So it's been a challenge. It's starting to get better on some products, but many are still delayed. So it's something that you sort of have to work with your builder to help understand and see what kind of delays might be experienced.
What do you ultimately chalk up these housing starts to? Is it the low interest rates? Is it the robust demand? When you sit down and talk to some of your fellow home builders, what are they ultimately chalking this all up to?
Well, I think there's a few things that have come together. One of the things that we were speaking about a lot prior to the pandemic and has really come to the fore now is just the lack of supply. Canada has a shortfall of housing units. Scotiabank came out with their statistics, noting that Canada has the lowest number of housing units per capita of any G7 country. And we did a study back in 2017 that talked a lot about what we called the baby boomlet of the millennials. And at that time, we were saying we're about 300,000 family-oriented housing units short in the coming decade, unless we pick up the pace, because the millennial generation is now in the market for either their first home or the older millennials looking to move up for more family-oriented housing as they have growing families. Now you throw in the pandemic and its situation, where all of a sudden houses started to become people's gyms, school for the kids, a home office, expectations changed, a need for more space, need for outdoor space, and an ability to move maybe a little further from town because the commute is different and is expected to be different depending on your job. So all of those things come into play. And then you add in some low interest rates, which were meant to incent people to buy things, and houses are no different. And of course, if you kept your job through the pandemic, it also means you probably saved some money. So there were some pent up savings that were also available. So you put all of those things together, and you see a lot of construction activity. Of course, we were fortunate in that we were able to stay operational through the pandemic as well. We were one of those places where people could invest their money. Other places, unfortunately, weren't able to.
When you look through that horizon lens, what does the outlook for home building look like?
Well, the outlook still looks quite strong looking ahead. I'll go back to our housing market index, which looks at current and future conditions. And our members are saying that on average currently, 80% are saying it's very good right now, and 70% see the future as good as well. So those indicators tell us that we expect things to continue strong. We also know that, as I mentioned earlier, in terms of demographics, that's all in place still. So we expect that to move forward and be supportive. And we do expect interest rates to stay low. They are predicted to climb a little bit in 2022, but again, still historically at very low and affordable levels, with the different parties coming in with platforms that should support more investment in housing and helping people get into homes. We expect a bright future in the coming months and years.